This comes as a kit. And one advantage of having a kit like this is it's a lot less likely to be damaged in transit. We have the instructions. This is, I'm sure, for measuring fuel or water. Alcohol burner, wrenches, nuts, bolts, O-rings, and the brass and stainless parts. A fuel bottle. I'm going to guess that hypodermic is to measure water. And then there is the base. We get to put that all together. So I've opened everything up, and it seems to be quite the complete kit. They give you instructions as to how these pieces go together. These are the top and the bottom clamping rings. This is a spacer. This bottom part ends up being the boiler, and the top part has a bearing that goes through there. And all of this is assembled with the support bracket that goes onto this column that mounts onto the base. And this alcohol burner has a little magnet inside of it. And the job of the magnet is to keep it in one place on the base. And then there's four little rubber feet to go on the bottom of the base. One thing I could not tell from the listing on Banggood was exactly how this worked. This is another version of the Hero of Alexander, the one that blew up on me. When you get this, this center plate has some grooves that have been machined or engraved in there. And those are your nozzles. So when you build up pressure in the boiler, steam will come out those nozzles and cause that thing to turn clockwise as viewed from the top. So pretty clever. And we should note that this one has a safety relief valve. So hopefully that won't blow up on you. Now this bearing and this piece of brass net come together with this piece screwed onto it. And there's a rather delicate little silicone O-ring in here, so you do not want to lose track of that. And that seals on this piece of brass here. Get a little closer to this and we can see these flow paths that have been machined in there. And they were machined or engraved in there. And another reason to only use distilled water so you don't get any mineral deposits or anything that might plug up this real fine opening. Going through the list, it's pretty simple. There are 16 of these, and the nuts have already been screwed on there so they don't get lost. There's two of these, and they are intended to mount this support column to the base. And so this one goes through a washer, goes through the base, and then this brass piece is down here on the bottom. And this brass piece is intended to separate these two support arms. These little brass standoffs go in between here. This part goes in through the top. And then this piece is shown here as being the thin piece of brass. And that flange goes up. That little silicone O-ring goes down. Goes on top of this piece. Under that, this has the red silicone O-ring. And it screws onto this brass piece. And the safety valve goes through this fiber washer and screws into the top of this piece. Then all the rest of these are used to clamp these pieces together as a sandwich. I did find it was necessary to leave these a little bit loose until you got this installed. Otherwise, the alignment of that hole would be off. So I put that on there tight, then I snug these up with those standoff spacers in there. Then I put this in. When I put this together, it was spinning pretty crooked. So you have to gently fiddle around until you get those O-rings and this part and everything to nest in the hole that's stamped in this. And once that was in place, that spins nice and true. When you go to put this together, I'd put every other bolt in there to begin with and then fill the remaining holes and just tighten these up finger tight till you make sure everything's in there and check it, make sure it's spinning true, which it is. Now I'll go back and make sure these are all good and tight. So it's all together. Spins real nice. Actually, I think it'll spin the other way. It's fairly heavy, so it will have a lot of momentum once it gets going. All in, once you lay the parts out and everything, you can put this together in about 10 minutes. It's a perfect case of it takes longer to talk about it than it does to do it. Unscrew this little safety cap, and I put 10 milliliters or 10 cc's, which is two of these. And I use distilled water, and this has denatured alcohol in it. Denatured alcohol will not cause a bunch of smoke and black spots. I don't know how high this fire needs to be, but we're going to start here. I have that fire pretty well centered under the boiler. And I will mention the fact that they say that this is a copper boiler in the listing. It's not. It's all brass. This is also not a Stirling engine. It's a steam engine. There is no gasket material in between these layers. They're just bolted together. My first attempt to run this was a failure. This filling valve was not tight enough against that. I had some steam leakage there, but I only had one nozzle working. And it tells you very clearly right here in the fine print to check to make sure that those nozzles are not blocked. And I thought I had. I put a black mark where the two nozzles are supposed to be. The one, you can see it right there. But on the other side, can't see it at all. So apparently, my inspection was not very good. I will take that apart and fix that problem. The flow path over here was not nearly as deep as this over here, and it did not exit the edge. So I have some real small engraving bits, and I used those to cut this in here and tried to get it the same size. Blew compressed air in where the safety valve usually is, and I felt how much air was coming out of these two holes, and they seem to be similar. So now I'm going to put it together and see how it works. I lit the fire on this about 2 minutes ago. It's a pretty good sized fire. 10 milliliters or 10 cc's of water is not a lot, but it will make a lot of steam, and the steam is now starting to come out of there. Shows up on the camera. There's a jet, steam jet coming out there. Okay, that alcohol burner got hot, and now the fire coming out of there is much larger. The fire's coming up all the way around the outside of that. So that's the little extra heat that it needed to get going. So I think actually now that pop-off valve is starting to open. Pretty impressive. That thing really gets going. The fire has gotten smaller. It was quite large there, and that's what got the thing going. And it's slowing down now, so I think it's run out of steam. Blow that fire up. This is very hot. You don't want to touch this until it cools off.